We'll talk later. Hi, you guys. How you doing? I'm Eliza Dushku. I'm your neighbor from Massachusetts. And I'm just going to tell you right now, I have nothing prepared to say to you today. I came up because, okay, I got a cheer for that. Thank you. Thank you. Just pure adrenaline. No, and Jim Wahlberg is a new friend of mine, and he invited me to come up, and I was really inspired that so many of you, like 8,000 people, were going to come out here tonight and today. And, you know, I heard that I did a TV show called Buffy the Vampire Slayer like 1,000 years ago. Do any of you guys know that show? So in a couple days, it's going to be 20 years since I was on Buffy. I was 17 years old when I started on that show. I'm such an old lady. But I'm an actress sometimes. I'm a Bostonian. But I'm an auntie. I have a niece who's 13. I don't know how old a lot of you guys are, but my niece is like 13. She's almost 14. She's going to be going into high school soon. She's teaching me Snapchat. I'm doing my best. But I love being an auntie, and I'm a sister, and I'm a daughter, and you know, this is an important event here today. Something a lot of people don't know about me is that I'm an alcoholic, and I was a drug addict for a lot of years. You hear people say, like, I am that, because I am that, and I'm always going to be that. But the difference between me and an alcoholic or an addict that still drinks and does drugs is that I'm sober. And I don't drink, and I don't do drugs anymore. Thank you. It's been 8 years, 8.5 years, and, you know, I don't want to preach to you guys. I just want to be honest with you. You know, when I was 14 years old, I took drugs. I probably started with pot. I went to parties. I was watching the movie If Only here, and I could really relate, you know? Like, one of the themes on the show Buffy that I did was, like, middle school and high school are really hard. They're really hard, you know? Like, we're freaking out inside. We have hormones. We've got cool kids. We're trying to fit. It's like, it's madness. It's really fun, too, but it can be so scary. And I just remember, like, I loved the first time I took a drug because I loved the way it made me feel. I loved the way it made me not feel. I didn't have to feel. And in the movie, it's like, oh, you're being dramatic. And I remember feeling that way. But I'll tell you, like, it was fun and I loved it until it wasn't. And, you know, drugs didn't love me. They didn't love my family. They definitely didn't love my friends that died. I have a lot of friends that are dead. You know, I went to a drug awareness event in Watertown a couple months ago, and they had, like, you know, these videos where I was, like, watching videos of people that were dead, you know, like Derek from my math class and, you know, Carly and kids that I drank and went to parties with and danced on tabletops with, and it was all fun, except they're on a screen now and they're dead and their families are at the event and I'm crying with their parents. It's real. I know it seems like it's just this normal part of life, but I'll tell you right now, I still dance on tabletops. I still have such amazing times, and I connect with people. And I'll be honest, I got sober at first for my family because I had gotten to a point where I felt so sick about myself. I was depressed. I didn't like myself. But I love my family, and I see all these, they are brave parents that are coming up here and pleading with you. You know, like going, I don't want you to be my kid who's in this picture that's died. And like, I remember my brother telling me he didn't want me to be around my niece because he didn't trust me and he didn't think, and I'm a really good auntie. I'm a really good auntie today. But you know what? He was right. Thank you for all the auntie lovers. He was right. You know, I'm a good person, but when I did drugs and I drank, I didn't make good decisions. I'm sure some of you can relate to that. And all it takes is one bad decision. And you don't have to live like that, you guys. Today, I have a really good time. I get to be an actress. I'm back in college. I'm a college student at 36 years old. It was something I always wanted to do and I didn't get to do for a lot of years because I was on a different path. But today, I got sober for my family, but today I'm sober for me and I'm sober for you. Because drugs and alcohol are powerful, but we're more powerful, you guys. We are. And there are so many incredible things, and there are so many, like, look at all these awesome people that are up here. I love that last guy that was up here. And the point is like, we're in this together. We're human beings, you know? And we can connect with each other, and we can protect each other. And all you have to do is, like, believe, you know, I don't drink or do drugs, like, one day at a time. And when my father was sick and dying of cancer 3 years ago, and one pill fell on the ground and nobody was around, and I remember looking at that pill and nobody would have known. I could have taken the pill right there. But I know how important it is. I don't want to be on that screen in a picture. I don't want to see my family, my niece, Sophia. I want to live my life for her. I want to see you guys live your life and be friggin' awesome. For real. You can do anything you want. I mean it. I'm a kid from Watertown, you know? And now I get to, like, do fun stuff and be in movies and be on TV. I couldn't do any of that if I had continued, like, living the way that I was living. And all you have to do, hang on. All you have to do, if you're in a situation and you're freaked out and you don't know what to do, just pause. Just wait a minute. If someone's offering you something and you have that weird moment of like, oh, what if I'm not going to be cool, just like wait a minute, you know, and find somebody, like talk to somebody. And I know Jim Wahlberg and a lot of these guys and a lot of the groups and a lot of the, you know, everyone wants to help you. Everyone's like, we're here, we're here, we're here. If you're in trouble, all you have to do is just say, I need help. And I'm like a real badass and like tough girl. Like that was part of my big thing. It was the hardest thing in the world for me to ask for help. And it was the most powerful thing I've ever done. Crazy, right? So please, just like take my word for it or don't. But hear me when I'm just being honest with you that you don't have to live like that. Your parents don't have to see you go away too soon. We're all in this together. We're gonna continue fighting this opioid madness all over in this state and all over the world. And, you know, follow me on social media. I'm always posting places you can go, people you can call. Thanks for listening to me ramble on. I really believe in you guys. I love you guys, and thanks.